In PowerDirector, the preview window is divided into the Media Library Preview window and the Project Preview window. In this episode, we will first introduce the functions and operations of the Project Preview window. In the Project Preview window, you can preview the edited content on the timeline and play clips from the Media Library, including imported materials, built-in text, transitions, and effects. The lower left corner of the Project Preview window provides options for playback. You can click the play or pause button, or use the spacebar to quickly play and pause. Pressing the stop button will return the playback point to the starting position of the timeline. Additionally, you can use the adjustment buttons next to it or the shortcut keys to fine-tune playback. In the lower right corner, you can click here to set the project's display aspect ratio, which will also be used during output. The 16:9 aspect ratio is the most common for horizontal videos. If you are editing a vertical video, you can choose 9:16. Please select the appropriate aspect ratio to meet your editing needs. Clicking the full screen view button or using the shortcut key F will expand the window to maximum size, allowing you to view your editing content more clearly. To exit the full screen view, you can click the X here or press the F key again to exit. After clicking the layout button, you can choose from three modes: landscape, portrait, and floating. Landscape mode is the default option in PowerDirector, ideal for editing standard 16:9 horizontal videos. The portrait mode extends the preview window from top to bottom, making it convenient for previewing 9:16 vertical videos. Floating mode allows you to detach the preview window, giving you the flexibility to reposition it freely or move it to an extended desktop. If you want to reattach the preview window to its original position, simply click the Dock Preview Window button in the upper right corner. Click the magnifying glass icon to adjust the preview display size for a clearer view of your edits. You can also move the mouse over the preview window, hold down the control key, and scroll the mouse wheel to quickly adjust the size. In this menu icon, you can select Preview Quality to adjust the resolution of the preview window. Higher resolution requires more computer resources. Generally, HD preview resolution is suitable for most computers, but if your device can handle it, you may choose a higher resolution for a clearer display. In the same menu, by selecting Preview Volume Meter, you can see the volume meter displayed in this location, which helps monitor and adjust the audio levels. When adjusting the volume, please be careful not to keep the volume in the red range for extended periods, as this can cause distortion and affect sound quality. If the preview is not smooth, you can click the Render Preview button. The Render Preview function performs a complete rendering and calculation of the clips, generating a temporary playback file to reduce the occurrence of stuttering during preview. Clicking the camera icon allows you to take a snapshot of the video. Move the playback point to the desired time for the screenshot, press the button, select the location to save the photo, and then click Save. The saved photo will appear in the My Media interface, making it easy for you to use it as material directly.